Kurt Russell returns for another round of family-friendly adventuring in the Netflix Christmas film, The Christmas Chronicles 2. This time around, Christopher Columbus takes over the director's chair, and he brings with him some of that Home Alone experience and Harry Potter magic. But a bigger budget or a grander script doesn't always translate into a better sequel, as is often the case with these Netflix movies. Hi guys, Michael Abayimi here, and today I'm reviewing Netflix Christmas film, The Christmas Chronicles 2. Set 2 years after the first movie, we once again catch up with the Perez family, who are busy vacationing in Mexico with their mom's new boyfriend. But Kate Perez isn't having any of it, choosing to sulk and make her displeasure known at any given opportunity. She makes a silent switch to Santa Claus to get whisked away from the unpleasantness of it all. But guess more than she'd bargained for when a disgruntled former elf seizes her discontent as an opportunity to set into motion a plan that would ruin Christmas for everyone. The Christmas Chronicles Part 2 is another surefire hit with families and kids this holiday. Kurt Russell continues to shine as Santa Claus, much like he did in the first movie, proving that the endearing qualities he displayed were far from a fluke. And Goldie Hawn proves to be his on-screen equal as Mrs. Claus, with the real-life couple sharing a chemistry that never once felt unnatural, even though they'd spent the bulk of the movie on separate adventures of their own. Other additions to the cast include Jazier Kadim Bruno, who we recently saw in the Robert Zemeckis' The Witches remake, and Tyrese Gibson. The former blended quite nicely with Proceedings, while the latter stuck out like a sore thumb. Blame it on the ubiquity of the Fast and the Furious franchise's past few years, but I just couldn't separate his appearance here from that other role. And with that, I transitioned into my biggest issue with The Christmas Chronicles 2, which was his over-reliance on CGI and spectacle. The movie leaned more heavily into his high fantasy through line, but in so doing, he loses most of the human drama at the heart of the first movie. The first film was grounded in reality, so that by the time the magic started to happen, it felt even more magical. But here, a significant portion of the film feels like it must have been shot against a green screen, with the actors' performances and my emotional involvement suffering as a result. The first film also had some edge to it, not being afraid to populate its tale with criminals and prostitutes, and an overall darker than usual approach that made you feel like it was not your typical Christmas story, which was one of the things that surprised me at first and endeared me to it the most. This one, by comparison, feels like it has been scrubbed clean of all that edge, leaving yet another generic adventure story that would no doubt appeal more to the little ones. The Christmas Chronicles Part 2 might be what most families need this holiday, a much-needed escape from the various horrors of 2020. Except it fails to improve on its predecessor in any significant way, while also losing much of what made that first movie so great to begin with. The result is a film that feels more like a Chronicles of Narnia knockoff than an actual The Christmas Chronicles sequel. I'll give the film a 5 out of 10. Have you seen either of the Christmas Chronicles films? Let me know in the comment section down below. Also, be sure to like this video if you enjoyed watching this review, and subscribe to the channel with notifications turned on if you'd like to see more reviews like this in the future. And until the next one, this is Michael signing off.